By EVE Monthly Demo Cup, here we are bringing you Innovare versus Granted in the winner bracket semifinals. We're already this far into the event. It's very really exciting. Thanks for everyone who's being here. I'm going to be your caster, Ink. Stoner is not going to be here today. I don't see him anywhere unless he comes on at some point in time. But if you see him in the chat, make sure you guys let me know. As for right now, Innovare, you guys should know who these guys are. They are the better part of Krakens, I would say. They are Kimpa, Quelle, and Mankey, combined with the power of Taz and Zetor. So basically, that's a pretty big Sweden powerhouse, with the exception of Quelle. So really, really exciting there. We also have Granted as well. Long Dong, Gnar, Marowak, R, and Mr. Gold. Marowak, R, and Mr. Gold, they're all from the Krakens or Sweden or Semper Fidelity team. So it's really exciting to see all these players here. Basically, all these players have been to an ISF or AIC at some point in their times as well. So it's a really hype match. Tons of high skill ceiling players here, and we have to see how it's gonna start. And the game is starting, so get hyped here, guys. Excellent. Hopefully my UI team bars are actually correct. If they're not, please let me know, guys. I'm trying to do a little bit new of a system here, so I hope you guys enjoy the series indicator in the bottom left corner. You can see the map score, and then in the top hand score I added a round score, so if those new viewers can just see what the current round score is. We're gonna see Mr. Gold and the rest of Granted playing a really solid defensive line. Yeah, and those team bugs are correct. So that is Granted on the defensive side, NRF if or the red side if you want to call that. On the blue or EU or offensive side, we have Innovare. And I'm sorry guys if I say their names incorrectly, but we have to do this here. Taz is scoping. He's scoping and he nades that blue truck. He's trying to get a pick. Working one, not getting anything though. He's gonna have to back off as that smoke does come out. So now we're gonna have to see what Innovare is gonna do here with Taz and Kimpa just playing on this one side here. Taz is just getting scoped out no matter wherever he goes. And Kimpa's gonna try to pick this joint. He gets taken down by the Kraken. The Kraken, just so much power here. It comes out from Quelle as well. Quelle getting a nice kill to Long Dong. Gnar just doing another good Kraken kill to Taz. It looks like Ari's using that Varesk, opting to go point man instead of anything else. So R is gonna have to defend this little pushy that's gonna come from Zetor and Quelle. They got that Innovare team. They're gonna try to push out through here, but I don't know what they're gonna be able to do against those three players of Granted that are just holding down that red container so well. It looks like R might go around for a flank at Forklift, and this could be bad for Quelle. Quelle's about to run into him, and yeah, R just takes him down, and Zetor as well is gonna be taken down from Marowak. Marowak also pushing him as well, putting really good pressure on those two players from Innovare at that those double doors. But Mankey though, he's got that M14, he's full HP, what damage can he do now? He's gonna come around at Forklift, he's got 30 seconds, gonna try to get that headshot, misses quite a bit, and Marowak again is just gonna get another easy kill by baiting his teammates intentionally. It's a really good job there from Marowak and the rest of Granted on winning that first round. We're gonna have to see how Innovare is going to adjust to this, if they're going to change their strategies up a little bit or not. And guys, let me know if the in-game sound is too low or anything like that. I'll adjust the levels for you guys. Mr. Gold is actually getting pre-fired through the wall, I think by a Kraken. R as well getting a nice kill onto Quelle. Marowak is actually using an XM8. Have to see what he does through this double doors. He's gonna push up and be aggressive. Zetor pushes into warehouse, gets a nice kill onto R. Oh, Zetor getting a nice double kill there onto Long Dong as well. That's gonna open up the two side if unless Marowak can hold it. And just like that, Granted, they're down three players. It's gonna be a 2v4. Marowak here sitting on the corner. He gets one kill. That's a really good job for Marowak, but he's gonna have to do that more without with the other team knowing where he's playing. Taz is playing inside of the one site. He's pushing in, going to try to kill Mr. Gold, but Mr. Gold, he's not gonna be able to do anything. He's just gonna be taken down at the front of the door there. It's all gonna be to Marowak. He's coming from the from their spawn. Marowak's gonna run into, I think that's Mankey, and Mankey's gonna push him back. Marowak has no HP. Yeah, Mankey with that pre-fight is just going to take Miracu down. And that's going to be tied up 1-1 overall here, guys. Wow, Innovair and Granted putting up a really good fight between each other in the first two rounds. Definitely really can't tell which team is going to pull ahead right now. Yeah, guys, if you're confused about the rule set, all blue capsule guns are allowed. That includes the Kraken and the Desmodus. We will be having a news post about that coming up very soon. So if you want to voice your opinions or feedback on that, you will do that on Monday. Just post on the comment section of that news post that we'll post on ESL. But yeah, as for now, the Kraken and Desmodus are allowed. We are changing our rules a little bit for August, so you're going to have to bear with us a little bit as we go through that process. Yeah, so Mr. Gold there is taking down Kimpa, but Taz gets a nice return kill to Mr. Gold. Nar gets a nice kill to Taz, and Zetor, as we just saw, took down Longdoing in the warehouse. So just a flurry of exchanges from everyone, but it really goes into the favor of Granted here. And it's going to be able to Zetor get a triple kill. He gets one, but at the cost of half of his HP. Ah, Zetor, what are you going to be able to do with this Kraken? That Kraken can one-shot headshot pretty easily if anyone is very low HP, but neither R and Gnar, man, that's going to be a tongue twister for sure. Zetor, though, is pushing out at this mid. He's going to probably see Gnar, or Gnar might look at him a little bit. But actually, they don't see each other, and Zetor's just going to get this bomb for free. It doesn't look like Granted had any concerns, it looks like Granted had no concerns about where that bomb was. Zetor just going to pick up the bomb and probably just going to plant inside of one. He might take his time, though. But he really can't take his time, so I guess he's just going to go straight in there and plant. Zetor's got to be really confused with what's going on right now, guys. Like, what is this? Free bomb? And R and R are just like, wait, he's still got to be in hole, right? There's no possible way he could be at one. Gnar and R from Granted, they're going to burn probably 10 or 15 seconds running to one, because they're really far away from that one site. Zetor just needs to plant right now. Gnar and R, I don't even think they know where the bomb is actually planted. Gnar's gonna go the long rotate. R's actually gonna go towards the one here. Yeah, so there's that 10 seconds shaved off the bomb timer right now. So Zetor, it's just 15 seconds that he needs to defend this bomb. He needs to defend against two players. He sees one come in, doesn't take the shot. He knows exactly where they are. Takes one shot. But doesn't get any kills yet. He gets flashed and gets taken down by a grenade. It's a really good take back there from R and Granted. Excellent job there. That's going to be 1-2. Charge diffused. Operation failure. Return to main. Yeah, guys, if you want to know about the first map or you want to help other people understand what map we're currently on, just tell them to look at the series counter in the bottom left corner. If it's 0-0, it's clearly the first map. If it's 1-0, it's the second map. We're going to use that from now on to count the series. And it looks like we had a dead round, so we are going to be here for a little bit. So back in this lobby, it looks like, who was it that DC'd? It might have been Taz, I think. Yeah, Taz has had some DC issues in the past. It looks like he still has yet to fix those. So we're going to have to see what occurs, or how long they actually take. I think it is a 10-minute max time, or maybe even 5 minutes. I don't even remember, but it's one dead round per map, guys. So this can only happen one more time with the other team on this map, so delays will be minimized as much as possible. Yeah, guys, swearing, caps, common spam words, they will time you out, delete your message and time you out, I believe, for at least a minute. I think it varies based on what infraction you actually do. Yeah, I don't think Moobot actually bans based on how many messages you send. I think you can send like 20 messages all at once and you won't get banned out. Maybe Twitch will ban you, but Moobot won't ban you for spamming messages. I should really write a command that lays out the rules. I will do that sometime soon, guys. Probably for tomorrow. Yeah, so the score is going to be 2-1 in the favor of Granted. You guys haven't missed anything yet. Just waiting on Taz to come back into the game. He's been scoping for that Innovair team. They look pretty good, but Granted though, they look just as good. Nothing really definitive has come out from these rounds just yet. Still waiting for a team to impose their dominance on the other team, basically. Remember, guys, if you look up in the top right corner, you can see what this is. It is ESL July Monthly Demo Cup. This is the tourney that ESL does once a month. Aside from all the other events we do, this is the common, usual monthly event. It's focused on EU, on the EU server. So I guess you could really say it's our EU Demo Cup, but NA players are allowed to play as long as they're within that ping limit. And we do actually see quite a bit of NA players. Yeah, but if you guys are curious about participating in ESL, then I have exciting news for you. In August, we're gonna have four events. So like the first 4 weekends of August, there will be an event every single weekend. 1v1 Summer Cup, 5-on-5 Summer Cup after that, NA Cup after that, and then our EU Monthly Demo Cup will again be on that second last weekend of August. So make sure you guys sign up. There's tons of events to participate in. I mean, if you're really dedicated, there's like three demolition tournaments that you could compete in. So I hope to see all those teams out there competing in all that, winning that AP, winning those guns. And it looks like we're so it can just be easy on them to change the settings around a little bit. So yeah, here comes up the suicide guys. Try not to spaz out too much about this. It is pretty typical and very common.
Enemy troops eliminated. Operation success. Return to main base. Your efforts are commended.
Remember, it is the first map. No one has yet to win a map yet, so it is just the first map here. We saw some good teamwork coming out from Granted on that last round of that retake. I wish I had a replay system to show you guys and to go over it. And it looks like it's the other team, Granted, now that need to kill themselves. Just name themselves right now. AmeriGuy 100 says, wouldn't it be funny if Granted were to win and were to knock Innovair down to the loser bracket? And yeah, that would be pretty funny, but the thing is Crackheads, they did get knocked down to the loser bracket twice or three or so times in the last like year that they were competing in ESL. And then they came back and won the entire thing, so you really have to hold off on that until they actually are out of the tournament completely. Loser bracket, you can still come back and win, and Crackheads has done it a lot, but here we are, starting to the match. And just crazy amount of action right off the bat. Longdoom and Maracru just getting a nade and a point man kill there. But Taz, through the ramp, through the forklift, just got a really nice kill. Almost gets that quick scope onto Maracru, but Maracru just takes him down. Though Mankey returns with a nice kill exchange onto Maracru. Wow, that's just going to leave that down to a 2v2 now as Mankey gets a nice double kill. Mankey's just going hot right now, guys. Just going around the corner, checking all the corners, getting all the kills. Wow.
Charge set.
Hey guys, so here it is. Quelle has planted the bomb. Mankey's gonna be trying to defend this. Mankey's very low HP though. He didn't get that initial headshot off into Mr. Gold, and Mr. Gold just got some really nice pre-fire kill. Actually gonna end up taking down Mankey as well. So all gonna be up to Quelle with this para in the close quarter areas of this silo. He gets hit a little bit, and that pre-fire from that death motor just comes around the corner and takes Quelle out. Yeah, we're definitely seeing the Granted team doing really well in their takebacks of defense. I mean, on defense on Hammerblow, it's really easy to take back two site. You don't really want to play in the site. Quelle should have probably been playing outside of the site to complement where Mankey was playing as well. Yeah, so Granted just took that map, took that round, I should say, and it's now 3-1. We do see Mr. Gold playing on the truck, and Zetor just taking him down with the death motors. Zetor going massive here, but Gnar has something to say about it. Takes him down with the Kraken. And Taz with a really nice scope kill onto Mariko. A nice double kill onto Nara, actually. Wow, Taz really trying to win this round for his team all on his own. Gonna plant that bomb down as well. Gonna go hop onto the barrels as well. Kind of messing it up a little bit, trying to smoke through that scope. But Long Dong coming around the corner. He's the last man alive. No, it's Long Dong and R. They're last man alive for their team. As Augur with the Long Dong, he's getting pre-fired by Kimpa. Long Dong gets one kill. Can't get a double. He's gonna have to back off a little bit here. He's only got 10 seconds to get 3 kills, guys. What is he gonna be able to do here? Anything at all? And that's gonna be timeout for Long Dong. He has no time at all. He's just gonna try to go for as many kills as he can. Taz tries to go for a knife kill. But Kimpa's gonna end that out, and that's gonna be the end of the round there. And that's gonna be the first, second round, I should say, for Innovair. 2-3. So yeah, we're going to be going into the third map, the third round, I should say, the round before the switch. This is where the teams will switch sides. So yeah, Mankey pushing really aggressively, pretty quickly, I should say, actually, through hole onto this ramp here. He's going to try to find Mariko, but Mariko's playing in his typical common little spot. See if Mankey's going to try to peek that or something. Mankey, though, gets some really nice foot shots onto, I believe, Longdoon, who was... playing in that warehouse. They are going to rotate R to play in warehouse as well, so looks like Granite has a really weak defense at 1, while most of the players are playing really heavy over at 2, and Mankey with a nice headshot onto Mariko. Mankey doing so much work for that M14 DMR this half. We do see 3 players from Innovair here sitting out on the front of 1, looking like they're going to probably try to push in here. Kimpa's going to smoke the spawn. Kimpa's actually very low HP, so he can't do much. Really going to have to bait his teammates a little bit. Mankey, though, it's another kill onto Mr. Gold. Mankey, oh my god, is going MVP here. And Zedor has snuck into the bomb site and is going to long range with that Desmodus onto Gnar. Wow, Zedor just getting all these crazy little sneaky kills. And R is going to be last man alive with Longdoom. They're going to have to take back the site from 5 players from Innovair. And just like that, Innovair are going to take all the players down. Going to tie it down to a 3-3 on the switch. So really good first half coming out from the offensive team Innovair. Granted, though, they probably wanted to win 4, maybe 5 rounds on defense, but really, what can you do against Innovair, Kimpa, Taz, Quelly? We're gonna have to see where this goes on here from here. Let's look at the Innovair setup. They're having a bit more of a focused setup than that we saw from Granted. Granted was a little bit more spread, a little bit more even. But we are going to see Zetor getting the first little kill onto Longdong, R getting a nice kill onto Kimpa. Yeah, so it's all tied up 4-4 right now, guys. Mariko, though, does take down Zetor, so Granted trying to push their a little bit of their advantage here. But Mankey, again, is pushing aggressively as well, getting that kill onto front of 1. Taz, where did you get that kill from? I think Taz got that scope kill all the way down at that alleyway. Really good job there from Taz. Oh, Taz gets another kill. Gets the kill onto R. Really good job there from Taz, getting a nice double kill. Really cementing the defensive stronghold that Innovair is trying to hold here. But Taz does get taken down by a Kraken, so that's going to be up to Gnar here. Can he do anything? No. Mankey's playing in a corner. Going to take down Gnar and his chance of trying to clutch in a 1v2. Actually, that would have been a 1v3 clutch if he was able to do that. But Mankey, of course, is going to shut him down with that M14. Really good job here coming up from Innovair, winning that first round on the switch. That's going to be 4-3 for the defensive team, which is going to be Innovair. And I should definitely remember to switch those UIs. Sorry about that, guys. That was one round that they were not switched. So we're going to have to see Mariko, Mr. Gold, and Nara. They all look like they're pushing towards this front of 1. So granted, they're going for a 1 push this round. I'm going to try to nade a little bit here. Some nice sneaky nades coming out from Mariko. That's a fast explosion grenade. But Zetor is playing right up on the box thing there. Yeah, and well, Quelle does get a nice, really good kill onto Meraku. I believe that was from Warehouse. So it's all going up to Gnar once again in a 1v4. This defensive stranglehold coming out from Innover. They're just playing really well so far, and they're taking a 2-round lead advantage. So it looks like Gnar is pushing up here. Gnar coming around the corner, he's going to be seen by Quelle. Quelle sees him, and what the heck? Gnar just gets a nice one dink onto Quelle. That Kraken is just so strong. Quelle was like even full HP and he got that kill. Couldn't land one shot. But you're going to run into a scope eventually, and Taz is going to take down Gnar and his attempt at a 1v4. So that's going to be 5-3 for Innovera, pulling ahead quite nicely on this defensive side right after the switch. So we are going to see Quelle running into that warehouse once again. There are three players from Granted sitting right outside here, so it's all going to be on Quelle's shoulders here to clutch this out and get two or three kills. Quelle is going to be peeking it. He's going to be playing long range apparently with the para. He's going to probably try to peek the window a little bit. Quelle's going to look away, and then R comes in, so it's all going to Quelle's aim here. Quelle, what can you do? Quelle can do nothing at R, and Longdong gets a double kill as well outside at the double door, so this is not going in favor of Innovera right now. They're only down to two players. Taz and Zethor up against four players of Granted. Granted have a complete hold on this two side. They have the entire site. So it's going to be Zethor and Taz to retake this site here. The bomb is going down as well as tons of smokes. Zethor gets one kill onto R. Zethor, what other kills can you do? He knows Longdong is playing around on this corner. But he can't get any more kills, and that's going to be Granted bringing it back a little bit, trying to close that gap. It's going to be 4-5, guys. Wow. Really good job on Granted to actually do something and not let Innovera just pull ahead. We did see a little bit of misplay there from Quelle. He played up on the rafters a little bit. He looked away, and that allowed R&R to come into the warehouse a little bit while Quelle was distracted at double doors. So Quelle's going to have to straighten up on that gameplay a little bit if he wants to defend his warehouse this time. And Longdong again gets a nice kill onto Mankey at double door. Mankey's playing really aggressive outside of that double door, and it looks like Granted is trying to use that buddy system there, so that's kind of why Longdong is just getting all those kills. But Taz does get one single kill over at one. I believe that was on Mr. Gold. So it is going to be tied up 4-4, and we do see both teams really setting up for this two-side. Granted, they should probably just try to get one pick or rotate. Trying to take this two-side with three players from Innovera over there is just going to be a huge uphill battle. Especially if their scope isn't actually looking anywhere there. They actually don't have a scope. We're going to have to see where Granted is going to go. They have about a minute left before they need to really make a decision on what they're going to try to do here. Yeah, Taz is scoping those double doors. He's definitely going to be the player to look out for. Meraku, though, takes down Zethor, but Taz takes down Meraku, and Quelle takes down Gnar. Quelle getting a nice double kill, though, really just destroying that double door area. And it's all going to be up to R. What can he do? R coming around the corner, going to peek through, not going to get the kill to Quelle. Quelle is just going to take him down, tell him to sit on the ground, and that's going to be 6-4. For Innovera. Innovera doing a really good job here. They're pulling it back once again. They did have a 2-round lead. They lost it, and now they have it yet again, and they're only 1 round away from winning this first map, guys. It is still a best of 3, so both of these teams really want to win this first map so they can have the easier advantage going into the second half. Alright, second map, and Gnar just gets a really nice kill to Mankey. Mankey wasn't paying attention. But what can you really say about that? Mr. Gold again got taken down. Mr. Gold is now 4-8, and And Kimpa kind of gets taken down by Longdoom. Kimpa! Is he really 0-8? What is going on here with Kimpa? Guys, I didn't even realize what was going on here, but Kimpa... Oh, Long Dong is just trolling Taz right now. And granted, they're going to bring it back to a 5-6. They have still yet to tie it up, but maybe they can work it back and win this next round? Look at those scores, 11-7 for Long Dong. He's really doing MVP work for his team. Mankey as well is carrying his team. He's probably like 10-6, considering he naded himself twice. But Kimpa is 0-8, that's probably 0-6, but wow. Mr. Gold is 4-7 as well, so that's just really strange to see these top players just bottom fragging so hard like this. Definitely makes you wonder how the game could have gone differently if each of these players had been playing more up to their standards. But as well, we're gonna have to see what happens here. Kimpa is finally gonna take on Longdoong, but they do back off. Kimpa with a really nice quick reload cancel there takes down Longdoong. Longdoong, and that's gonna be Kimpa's getting his first kill, really. Or actually, no, I think that's his third kill because he did nade himself twice. Yeah, guys, unless the players tell me how to pronounce their names differently, I'm going to pronounce them as I read them off the screen. I'm really not going to go talk to each individual player and ask them specifically how to pronounce their name. So yeah, that's going to be R getting a nice kill onto Kimpa. Gnar is still in there somewhere, just floating around. But R is going to take down Quillia. Nice para fight here. R really taking the advantage out there. Taz, take down Gnar. It's all going to be tied up 3-3 right now, guys. Who is Innovera going to win this round? They have a really good defensive layout right now, but Taz is all the way over at 2. He kind of needs to rotate before Zetor gets squeezed in here at 1. Mankey is going to be the first one on the scene here to see Mr. Gold, I believe, is who's pushing up here. Mr. Gold is already in the site, and he's just going to sit around the corner. But Mankey sees him, and Zetor takes down R. Mr. Gold, what are you doing? Mankey's going to take down that final kill on Maraku, and that's going to be 7-5 for Innovera. Yeah, guys, so that's going to be the first map win to Innovera. That's going to be 1-0. Yeah, look at all these viewers coming in as the hype just builds even more as they recognize these names. So yeah, that was Innovera. They took the first map against Granted in the Winter Bracket semifinals. So that was on Hammerblow here. We saw a really good gameplay coming in from each of the teams in the first half of the map. It was tied up 3-3 before that switch. Then Innovera took a two-round lead. We did see Granted, they tried to bring it back a little bit. They brought it back twice, actually, but again, Innovera was just too strong and brought it to a 7-5 victory. And here we go, guys. The second map is going to be India. We definitely want to see Granted winning this map so we can go to a third map. However, if they lose it, it will be Innovera winning and going to the Winter Brackets finals tomorrow, which we'll have for you. So you guys just gonna wait for these for R to really just ready up. We're gonna see Innovera on defense once again. Just waiting on this countdown to start before we get started here. And it looks like Mr. Gold has crashed. Pretty typical experience coming up from Mr. Gold, if anyone else is aware. I'm gonna have to wait on him to get back into the game. For now, let's just take a look at the bracket and see what's happening over there. So guys, we do see Vixen, they're actually pulling through quite easily. They've beat down Luxys, Genix Gaming. They're going to be going up against Neutralize. Neutralize beat down Exile as well. I know those were two games that we were waiting on to finish as well. So Noir beat out Old Style Clan, and they're just waiting in the Winter Bracket Semifinals as well. We'll probably try to cast that after this game finishes. As well, heading down into the Losers Bracket, we've got so many teams have already been knocked out. We've got Curse and Luxes going against each other right now. Curse beating out District. We have Vita beating out Excessive, and Vita and Oldstyle are going to be playing against each other. Five Fools and Team Pacific are currently playing, as well as XL, Golden Rose, GenX Gaming, and Celsia. Those teams are still playing at the moment. Yeah, I see some predictions from the chat that they're calling a 2-0 for Innovera now because it's India. Hey guys, try not to spread misinformation in the chat. We'll time you out if you do that. It can cause just so much confusion in the chat, especially with like the text and how it works in the chat. So yeah, really, just spreading misinformation or trying to troll is just... Yeah, unless you're making a prediction, then it's whatever, but... Yeah, so still waiting on Mr. Gold to get back to their game. He's probably gonna have to upload his AC and everything else, and then start AC back up, and then just get that all underway. And here we go, Mr. Gold is back in the game. We're going to be having this game starting very soon, I hope right now. And yes, here's that countdown, guys. Get ready for it. This is the ESL AVA July Demo Cup. This is the Winter Bracket Semifinals between Granted and Innovera. Or Innovera, I should say. Innovera won that first map, 7-5, I believe. On Hammerblow, so the map score is currently 1-0 for Innovera, as you can see in the bottom left hand of the corner. So we are going to see Innovera playing on the defensive side. They are going to push that pillar very hard here. Zetor coming out strong here with nice kill to Gnar. Zetor as well still pushing as well with believe that's Quelly. Quelly trying to get some pre-fire shots here down into the opening corner there, into the spawn alleyway. R, though, does a nice kill to Kimpa with that para. And look at all of this. Look, there's four players from InnoVer just playing that pillar. Just leaving open two and their spawn. Like, this is just absolutely crazy, guys. But really, what can you expect from InnoVer? They have the bomb, so why wouldn't they be standing there? Mystical, though, gets a really nice kill onto Mankey. Gets a really nice double kill. Double kill headshot onto Mankey and Quelly. Trying to get control of this bomb once again. But Taz is going to even it out with that kill into Mr. Gold into a 2v2 situation. We are going to see Zetor covering the flank as Longdung is going to be coming around there. And R is probably going to be coming around from the spawn alleyway. So yeah, basically both of the teams are just waiting for the other team to move around, but they're definitely just not heading in the same direction as each other. Taz is just going to be scoping this hallway as long as possible, and it looks like actually Longdoon came back, and they're both going to try to come from this way. Taz getting a nice kill onto R. R tries to pick up the bomb. Longdong just get the bomb, but he's going to have to try to get kills here. He's very low HP though. He's going to try to kill Taz. He gets a nice kill onto Zetor. But he's gonna have to push Taz here. Longdong coming around the corner. He's half HP. He won't tank. Taz missing the shot. He's gonna run back out. Oh, Taz just keeps missing shot after shot. And that's gonna be Longdong winning it out in a 1v2. Excellent job for Longdong. That's gonna be 1-0 for that offensive team. Granted, excellent job to them. Yeah, we're gonna have to see what Granted are gonna try to do here. They have three players stacked at the mid though. They have Miraku watching that pillar, and they have R trying to go do something at two. I think they know that Taz isn't playing in that two site, so I don't know, maybe they're just gonna try to slow walk into that two backyard. The bomb is heading that way, so it's all gonna be on Kimpa's shoulders here to do something. Kimpa is gonna peek, and he might see R very soon. Yeah, so we have Gnar and R here. They're just playing around the corner from Kimpa. Kimpa is not quite peeking yet, but he's going to run into... let's see what Kimpa tries to do here. Kimpa, he gets spotted by R. Kimpa takes him down. Mr. Gold is also going to come around the corner, but just not going to peek him. I mean, Mr. Gold is all the way at mid. I'm sorry for that guess. It's Gnar that we are looking at right now. He needs to come around this corner and maybe take down Kimpa. But he needs support from the rest of his team, and here comes Longdong. Longdong is just going to come around the corner pre-firing, but Kimpa another headshot kill. And that Kraken is just going to end Kimpa as Gnar just takes him down. Mr. Gold takes down Zetor on that rotate, I believe. So it's going to be a 3v3 here, but no one from Grand is actually in the bomb site. They're just sitting at mid, waiting on those rotation kills. Really smart play here from Granted if they can get any kills. Quelly did do some damage onto Granted. As you can see, Gnar is just very low HP right now. So yeah, it looks like Mr. Gold and the rest of Granite are just going to try to come up from mid. Quelly trying to jump but not getting a kill. He actually gets a kill to Mr. Gold. Misses that the other kill to Miraku. Miraku is just going to go right into that bomb site. So I think that was Kimpa that got taken down there from... oh no, it wasn't Kimpa. I don't know who died there, guys, but sorry about that. Two players here from InnoVera, they're going to be coming into the bomb site now. Quelly, very low HP, he's going to be taken down, but Mankey is ready, takes down Gnar. Miraku is very low HP as Mankey just taps him once in the face. Mankey, what can you do? Gets a nice headshot kill onto Miraku. And that's going to be it. Mankey clutching technically in a 1v2 there. Gonna get the bomb defused, gonna tie it up to a 1-1 in the first two rounds here. Return to main base. Your efforts are commended. Yeah, and just like that, so Innovera have tied it up 1-1. Innovera, they need to win this map in order to take the series, but it's Granted that needs to win this map to take it to a third map. Yeah, so Gnar is just trying to pre-fire here with the Kraken. He's got two players sitting at the bottom of the stairs, though, that he's going to have to pre-fire. I don't think he's going to be capable of doing that without a smoke or a nade or support from his team. Marakuru, though, gets a really nice kill into Kimpa. I believe that was all the way down over at the spiral as Kimpa was pushing out aggressively and Marakuru was just sitting and waiting. But Mankey, though, is now finally going to start pushing up on the stairs. This might catch R off guard. Gnar is going to get naded, but not very much. He avoids that nade really well. And as we see, Innovera, they pushed that stairs, they got a kill, and they backed off, guys. That's a really good job there from Innovera. Really good strategic play and decision-making coming out from Innovera. Are they going to be able to follow this up, though, with this one push coming out here? Longthong just pushes into vent and gets taken down immediately by Zetor, and no one from those one stairs actually pushed out, so granted, they kind of just left a few of their teammates hanging dry. So yeah, Gnar here. Mr. Goldo getting a nice kill onto Zetor, but Gnar is very low HP. Marakuru gets a nice kill onto Quelly, and that looks like Site 1 control is in the favor now. Granted, but Taz is trying to get some scope kills here on the orange box. He misses that first one onto Gnar, but he's going to try it again. Mankey, though, gets taken down. He peeks, and Gnar is just there waiting with that pre-fire. Even more pre-fire coming in from Gnar. We do see Taz in a 1v2 situation right now. Marakuru and Gnar, they probably aren't going to take any of his shots as they are both very low HP. Taz unable to get that nice shot onto Marakuru. Marakuru's just going to take him down with a nice headshot. And that's going to be 2-1 for Granted. They're really doing an exceptional job right now defending off, or actually being really aggressive and bringing through that defense of Innovera. A little bit of mistake there from Longdu. He just rushes out to mid and there's two players just waiting for him. Kimpa takes him down. Mankey tries to push through the vent for some reason, and Mr. Gold takes him down with a nice headshot. And Quelly takes down Gnar somewhere in the spiral. Kimpa as well taking down Mr. Gold. Art with a nice kill onto Quelly. So just exchange kills coming out from both of the teams here. It is going to be a 2v3 for Granted. They're down one player currently right now. The bomb is rotating through the spawn. I have no idea where it's probably going to go now that Marakuru has died and was unable to take control of that one site. Zetor, really good job from here on getting that kill. So we're going to have to hop onto R here, see where he goes and what he does.
Enemy troops eliminated. Operation failure. Return to main base.
Yeah, guys, so getting back into this game, it is 2-2 right now. So there are two rounds left before that side switch. We are seeing, granted, they look like they're going towards two, I see. There's Marakuru in the spiral, and Mr. Gold and Longdong, they're just sitting in the mini spiral, or the staircase, whatever you guys want to call that. So it's going to be up to Mankey to maybe get a headshot kill here on Mr. Gold if Mr. Gold's trying to nade. They are trying to shoot each other a little bit. It's just one shot from Mankey will get that headshot kill, but Mr. Gold is getting a little bit more consistent shots. Mankey, though, is actually going to push up mid here. He's going to be going aggressive. And Mr. Gold is going to take him down with that Kraken. Really good job from Mr. Gold to pay attention to Mankey's playstyle there. So let's see, it's going to be 4v5 right now for the defensive team. They're going to have to get a pick or something. It's going to be up to Kimpa and Taz to defend this. But we're going to have to hop on board to Kimpa here. And it looks like Kimpa here might get a nice double kill. He actually doesn't get any kills at all. It's Taz who gets the first kill. And then gets that second kill onto R there. And Koli gets a nice kill onto Marakru. Return to main base. Your efforts are commended. Yeah, so that's the defensive team there. They won that round. It's now 3-2. So there's only one more round left with that side switch, and you definitely want to bet that Innovera is definitely wanting to win this to take it to a 4-2 before the switch. But of course, granted, they definitely want to tie it out before that switch as well. They definitely want to win as many rounds as they can on offense. We do see R and Gnar. They're just kind of pushing to this one stairs a little bit. And just like that, granted, they push into that one site, they take down Mankey and Zetor. Taz takes down Lungdung though, but it's going to be Marakru who gets the final two kills here onto Taz and Quelly. I don't think he saw Kimpa at Vent as well. Is Marakru going to get a triple kill here right now? He looks away from Vent, he's going to have to look at it. Kimpa comes into the site, gets a nice double kill. Man, I really wish I was looking at that. He takes down Marakru, takes down Mr. Gold. He's got 20 seconds left. The remaining player is inside of the one. That nade kill from Kimpa! Oh my god, guys, Kimpa! Just randomly throwing a grenade into the bomb site. Really good heads up play there from Kimpa. Winning that sixth round into the favor of Innovair. Kimpa, 12-4, definitely redeeming his performance in the prior map. Hey guys, so there is that side switch. We're now going to see Innovera on the offensive side, while we do see Granted on the defense. Going to have to see how what Granted is doing here. They're pretty much standard setup, three players inside of one. One player watching in the mid area. Charge set. And what a crazy situation we are in now. Taz has planted the bomb in the site, so we're gonna have to look at him as he's the player that's gonna run into these two players first. Mankey needs to rotate now. Taz gets a nice single kill onto Gnar and gets a nice double kill finished off. Taz just holding down that site all by himself. Excellent job from Taz. And it's the score is 5-2, guys, for Innova. Win two more rounds, guys, and they will take the series 2-0. Remember, it is a best of three. gonna have to see where Innovair is gonna try to go right now. Looks like they're trying to distract that pillar a little bit, as well as mid, but the real meat of their team is heading over towards that two side with Taz and Kimpa. Kimpa is just gonna peek out and get a nice kill into Long Dong as well. Quali just gonna get a nice find a kill somewhere at mid. I don't actually know where he got that kill. But yeah, it looks like Miracru is going to try to rotate through the spawn, easily going to take down Quelly, as Quelly had no HP at all. That bomb is going to rotate over to one, and they confirm that both players are sitting inside of one, so Taz is going to get locked down that rotate, and then Kimba's just going to rotate over to two, plant the bomb, and then they're just going to play it from there. So it's really going to be on Miracru and R to kill Taz on that rotate. As Kimba is very low HP, and if Taz cannot get these kills, I don't see how Kimpa is going to be able to get all these kills when Miracru and R have just a lot more HP. But yeah, here, we're going to have to hop onto Taz. It looks like they're going to try to bait each other out here a little bit. Taz is missing all these shots. It's all going to be up to Kimpa. He's got about 15 seconds left, 13 seconds left to defend this bomb. He's going to be taking it down. That's going to be the third round going to Granted. A little bit of a misplay there coming out from Innovair a little bit. They could have had Taz delay just a few seconds longer, and maybe Kimpa could have delayed a little bit longer inside of the bomb site. Or maybe they could have even just gotten kills or landed their shots, but... but yeah, who knows what happened there, but all we know is that Granted is trying to bring it back a little bit. They definitely don't want to lose this map, they don't want to go into the loser's bracket. And we're going to see Long Dong here playing. Yeah, and there we go. We see Long Dong taking down Quelly. Mankey takes down Long Dong. So yeah, that's going to be Zetor and Mankey. Mankey sitting at the bottom of that vent. Zetor sitting over there at pillar. We have R, Gnar, and Mr. Gold still up for Granted right now. Innovair, what are you guys going to do? Bomb is sitting at that pillar. Zetor isn't making a move. He's probably just going to wait on Mankey to do something to catch someone off guard. But Granted, they're just going to sit still for the remainder of this round. And we finally see Zetor. He stands up. Is he going to move any bit more forward? Yeah, guys, so they're just going to be sitting out here and waiting. Mankey, of course, he's just going to go through that vent in collaboration with Zetor coming down the stairs. R is peeking the stairs right now, so Zetor might get caught off guard a little bit. R is definitely going to call us out here. Gnar takes down Mankey with that scope shot. All going to get up to Zetor in a 1v3. Can he get any of these kills inside of the one side? He's just playing around the pillar. Doesn't get the scope. It gets R, though. He needs to reload, though. He's going to try to pistol the scope. He's running out of time. And Mr. Gold was coming out from behind him. Just ran out of bullets and couldn't reload. Good job there. Good try from Mankey there. But Granted, they're bringing it back, and it's 4-5 for Granted at the moment. And it looks like Innovair, they're just going to keep doing pretty much the same kind of slow strategy here, but Mankey does push out pretty aggressively in the first 20 seconds, as well as Kimba pushes out, but Mystical Gold is just getting so much damage on the Innovair team right now. Takes down Mankey, Kimba is solo HP, Taz missing a shot as well. Kimba's going to try to peek again, gets the kill onto Kimba, but at the cost of him dying to Taz. But I don't think that matters, as pretty much all of Granted have rotated over to 2. Well, into the 2 alleyway at least, or 2 connector. Quelly is going to be the only player inside of 2 with that bomb. He does take down Gnar with that death modus. Really good shots there coming out from Quelly. And Zetor has locked down the one site, so he's going to be able to take this rotate, try to get some rotate kills here. Miracru is spotted by Zetor. Zetor is going to try to come down through mid here, going to try to get him. Is he going to see him? He sees him, gets the easy kill, and that's just like that. It's all going to be in a 1v2 for R. Ours is sitting at 2 here, and,
Charge set.
Yeah, so it's gonna be R, who is last alive here. He's gonna be coming through the, his spawn, basically. He is all smoked out. He's got 20 seconds, 13 seconds to, defuse the bomb. R is gonna be coming around here. He's gonna be coming to the site. It's called out. Zetor takes the kill. That's gonna be 6-4 for Innovare.
Your efforts are commended.
And yeah, Quelly is already up on the vent, or trying to go up on the ladder at least. He might get hit by a nade. He actually misses that grenade quite easily. And just a really strong defensive hold on the one stairs here from Granted. They killed two players, but the real push is going over at two. And this is really confusing that Innovare is going to be sacrificing two players just to get control of a bombsite. Quelly though, what the heck, Quelly, you just got a double kill on Long and R. You just pretty much put the favor back into your team here. Marifu is going to be trying to run into Quelly a little bit. Gnar is now last man alive as Quelly gets a nice nade kill onto Marifu. Quelly just got a triple kill this round. Definitely MVP for his team. Here comes the knife. Both of them kind of failing, but Taz finally getting the knife kill. That's going to be 7-4, and that's going to be 2-0 for Innovare. Really good job in the winner bracket semifinals. We are going to see Granted play in the loser bracket. We are going to see in the winner bracket finals Innovare going up against the winner of whoever won the other winner bracket semifinals. But we will definitely have at least one more game coming up for you guys. We will have probably two though. No guarantees though because there are delays. Thanks guys for tuning in. I hope you guys enjoyed watching Innovare and seeing them play. Was definitely really interesting seeing them play against Granted. Both of those teams are really good. I would not be surprised to see them both in the grand finals.